What do you guys do when you need something? Whatever it is.
You go get it.
Go get it? Okay. How do you get it? How do you find it?
Research.
Google
it. If you Google it, give me a thumbs up. That's simple. So as consumers are Googling, what do you guys think they're searching for if they're trying to find something related to heating and air conditioning? Heating and air conditioner? What if it's 114 degrees and you're in Arizona? What are you looking for?
Air conditioning.
Cool me down.
Okay. What if the thing's broke? It won't turn on. It's like 100 degrees in your house, sweating, can't sleep.
Why did my AC break?
Why did my
AC break? Reliable.
Reliable AC? What else?
AC repairman.
There you go. AC repair, air conditioner repair, air conditioning repair. That's what consumers are searching for. They're literally just AC repair near me, AC repair in Phoenix, Arizona, AC repair in Mesa, Arizona, AC repair in Plano, Texas, AC repair in Dallas, Texas. Wherever they live, that's what they're searching for. The most frequently searched for term there is in existence in the HVAC world is AC repair or heater repair or furnace repair. That is the top search terms there are, the highest demand of everything. If you are from Chicago and you have no heat, you're freezing. It's cold. There's snow on the ground. What are you looking for? You're from Chicago.
How to start a fire.
How to burn my phone book. Right. What else? What are you looking for in Chicago?
Furnace or boiler repair.
Furnace or boiler repair. Perfect. What if you're from California, Redding, California? I know we have on here. What are you looking for? Furnace or boiler repair?
No, we're looking for air quality.
Yeah.
Move the smoke from my house. I get that so much. Okay. It's cold. We'll pretend it's cold. What are you looking for?
Heat pump repair or furnace sometimes, depending on where you are in California.
Heating. We're looking for heating.
You know that the West Coast thinks a furnace is something in Freddy Krueger's basement. Like it eats small children. There's fire. Those are scary.
We don't have basements.
You don't, right? It's entirely different depending on where you're from. If you're from Seattle, Washington, you're not looking for furnace repair. You definitely heat pump repair. Definitely heater repair. So every single word that is used in a search matters. When you guys go visit your dealer and you see them say heating and cooling, no one searches for cooling, but dealers and inexperienced marketing companies. No one searches for cooling repair. Coolant is something in your car. It's not something consumers search for. So if I'm heating an air conditioning company and on my website is essentially just a giant list of pages that I'm trying to get into a drawer that a consumer who wants to buy my stuff is actually going to find me. That's the whole process of marketing. What do I want to sell? Know those terms. I want to sell what people are buying. That's most important. It's not I want to sell air conditioners. I'm not going to compete with Home Depot and Walmart and all your main manufacturers. I want to service consumers, homeowners who have a need, a problem, and they want to get it fixed. So they're looking for repair, or they're buying a house and an inspector tells them that you got to get your air conditioning or your heating and air conditioning system inspected before we're going to clear this condition to close. So if I was buying a house and a realtor or an inspector told me you need to get your air conditioner inspected before we're going to clear this to close, what would you search for?
AC inspection or an AC inspector.
Absolutely. Have you ever been to a dealer's website and seen the page called AC inspection? Nada. You can't sell something that doesn't exist. You guys, when you look at Google, all Google is a giant filing drawer. In your office, you have a filing system. And in your filing system, you have pieces of paper. I don't have very many pieces of paper here. But if this page says heating and air conditioning and heat pumps, no Google. If this page says heating and air conditioning and I give it to Google and I say, hey, do me a favor, file this so somebody can find it. Where are they going to put it? If you think about this industry, really technical, it's actually not even that technical. It's more logical and pragmatic than technical. Every page on a website has to go into a drawer. In order for the dealer to make any money, they need to be in the top 10 of whatever number of pages are in that drawer for that particular service, and consumers need to be looking for it. You guys, give me a city. AC, repair.
Akron, Ohio.
Spell it. What, Ohio?
A-K-R-O-N.
Oh, Akron, Ohio. This number right here, you guys tell me if you can see this. How many pages are in this drawer?
2.8 million.
2.8 million. In order for your dealer to make any money, they either need to pay to show up here. These are Google local service ads, advertising. They have to pay every time somebody calls. These are pay per click, Google AdWords. Every time somebody clicks on one of these links, money comes off their credit card. They have to get listed in Google's business directory. This is step four, local advertising or local marketing. The way they get listed is they need to have a listing that has the highest number of reviews, most accurate listing, and most frequently updated listing. This is in Google Business or Google My Business account. And it's only a three pack. It's gonna show the top three listings here. This is free. It just takes labor. Just takes work. Constantly publishing new content, updating it, and making sure you're driving reviews where it matters. Not to Yelp, not to Angie's List, not to Better Business Bureau. You're driving reviews where it matters. Google My Business. Everything below the Google My Business, this is called organic SERP, search engine results pages, organic search. Anybody want to give an example or how many listings do you think show up right now in the organic SERP? It's the same on every search if you're on a computer.
A ton, a lot, the 2.8
million. 2.8
million.
And on the first page, there are 10. 10. How many of you guys, when you do a search, go to page two? Anyone?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes?
I do not usually.
Do not? Anyone else?
Kurt? Yeah, I usually do, only if the websites look kind of fishy.
Okay, if the front ones look fishy, you'll go to page two. Anyone else?
I only went to page two, like in college, when I had to research a topic for a report just to dig deeper. Like never when I wanted to like buy a product or service do I think I ever went to the second page.
Perfect. Christine?
But yeah, I mean, I think we've all out of curiosity gone to other pages, but I found that pretty consistently my most relevant finds are on that first page, 1 through 10.
1 through 10, below the maps. How many of you guys click on these ads?
I don't even get them. I have an ad blocker.
You have an ad blocker. You don't get them?
I usually don't do it because I always feel like there's going to be a virus or something on them.
Absolutely. Kurt, do you click on the ads?
Sometimes by accident, but I try not to because like say you type in like what the other day, yesterday I typed in Wayfair and I clicked on the ad one by accident. It was like type in your email to get 10% off. And I was like, no. And so I had to back out and go like down three rows to the regular Wayfair, which took me directly to their website. Like the ad took me to a different page before the website. Sorry, it was just annoying.
So that is called the landing page. And if you're going to invest in pay-per-click, you got to have a landing page because you're trying to measure your conversions. If you drive them to the homepage of a site where a consumer actually wants to go, then you you cost them money. That was like $40 for your click, and their actual listing was below that, which, for bigger companies, they want to occupy the entire front page of Google. So they'll put ads up and they'll pay for people who already know who they are, who could have went to their website just because they don't want competitors to advertise using their brand name. You look for a brand name, someone you wanted to buy something from, you've already used them, obviously. So they're just trying to make sure they're trying to block competitors from snagging their customers who are looking for their names.